I have always loved Sherlock Holmes, particularly the modern adaptation with the BBC. And I heard about it online and just thought, well, hey, I have a deerstalker, so why not?
I'm here because I found this event on internet, and I think it's fantastic. It's something different, something really fun to do in London.
I love Sherlock Holmes. I've been interested in it ever since I started university. I love the stories. I love the television show. And when I heard about this event happening online, I really wanted to be a part of it. I thought it was so cool. So I decided to show up.
What's the timeless magic of Sherlock Holmes, do you think?
I think it's just the complex mysteries. I mean, there are so many books out there that deal with these like locked room mysteries, and we just all love trying to piece it out ourselves. And then you have just someone who can just do that, and it just makes the world seem a whole lot simpler for a second when Sherlock Holmes is on the case.
I think it's that they both represent and break stereotypes of the time that they were created. Everyone holds them up as like one of the examples of later Victorian literature, but there's all these really interesting social undercurrents that are going on in this book, how the atmosphere is depicted, how modernization is shown throughout the entire story. Well, not like the entire story collection, I mean, but I think it's just kind of that change in both the setting and the characters themselves. I think that's what's entranced everyone for all these years, and plus just the fact that the mysteries themselves are awesome.
I think it's the intelligence, really. I first started reading Sherlock when I was about 13, 14 years old. And what fascinated me from the very beginning was the way he solved the crimes, the intelligence, the absolute passion that he had for his job. So I think what always fascinates people is when you bring passion to what you do. So that's really what fascinates me about Sherlock.
Why do you think the recent BBC adaptation seems to have captured people's imagination so much?
Well, I think it's because it's just fantastically written. It's written by people who are passionate about the source material, and it just does a fantastic job of updating them. So the characters stay so true to what they were in the original Conan Doyle works, but they're in this modern setting, and every reaction you can still see these original characters, and it's just, I love it.
I think probably because Benedict Cumberbatch is pretty good looking, and I think actually it's really, really well directed.
Because he's Benedict Cumberbatch, you can't. He's so handsome and talented, and that's why I really like him.
I think in a lot of ways everyone was just ready for another Sherlock Holmes. I was at a convention just this past weekend, and Mark Gatiss was talking about how, it was just timely. It just occurred to them, and there was another Afghan war going on, of all things, and they just thought, well, hey, let's try our hand at that. And I feel like everyone was just really ready to see like how those two could fit into this new world where everything is so confusing and so technological, and just to see how Sherlock Holmes kind of makes a name for himself in this new age.
Very intelligent, very demanding television as well. It makes you think. As a viewer, you don't want to have everything presented on a silver platter, so you want to think along with the case, which in the new series is the best part, really.
Benedict and Martin seem to have captured something very special. Would you agree with that?
I would definitely agree with that. I think that everyone just works great together. I'm so excited for the next series. I am expecting that my expectations will be completely wrong, but in a most excellent way.
Last season, wow. It was amazing. It was incredible. I loved the, I feel like there was a definitive shift from sort of plot and case-driven antics to a lot of character development. And that was refreshing to see, particularly in Benedict Cumberbatch's character. I feel like we sort of dispelled a lot of this whole machine mentality that we sort of had with him. And that was really refreshing. And it was acted phenomenally. Everyone did a phenomenal job of bringing about that that reconciliation of Sherlock and Watson, which I feel like was the central focus of that series. And for the next series, I mean, Mark Gatiss put out a tweet last week or a couple weeks ago, expect the unexpected, and I am expecting the unexpected, as always.